Hello kids, I am your teacher Surbhi Roy. How are you all doing? I hope you all are fit, fine and in good spirit. Today, as you all know, is 1st of July and this day is dedicated to the gods who are present on the earth to save us and take care of us from the evil diseases. Yes, you are right. I am talking about the doctors. In India, the Doctors' Day is celebrated on 1st of July every year as a way of paying respect and homage to the contributions made by Dr. Vidhan Chandra Roy, who left an incredible mark in the history of medical profession. His birthday and death anniversary falls on 1st of July. A doctor has a very important place in our society. Doctors treat the sick people who suffer from any kind of diseases. Doctors treat the patients in hospitals and clinics. They have nurses and compounders for their help. Now, I will show you what the doctors use to treat their patients. Number one is stethoscope. Children, you must have seen the doctors with this instrument. This is used to hear the sound made by heart, lungs or intestines. Number two is white coat. The white coat is worn by the doctors so that we can easily recognize them. This white coat also marks an impression of cleanliness. Number three is mask. This is a mask. Nowadays, majority of the people are using masks. The masks prevent germs from entering our body through the nostrils and through the mouth. Number fourth is medicine. These are medicines which the doctors prescribe us when we are ill. Kids, as you all know that coronavirus is a deadly virus and has spread everywhere in India as well as in the world. We don't have any medicine or vaccine for it till date. As you all know that prevention is better than cure. This proverb applies in this situation also. On this Doctor's Day, I talked to Dr. Aditi Dev. She is a frontline warrior and has saved many lives during this pandemic. She is the real life hero in white coat. So I am going to show you my online conversation with Dr. Aditi Dev. Welcome, Dr. Aditi Dev.
Hello, children. How are you? I'm Dr. Aditi Dev. I'm an ENT surgeon by profession. I've been practicing in Kolkata for the last 21 years.
First of all, we all want to know what is COVID-19. And how does it spread?
Today I am here to tell you something about the COVID-19 disease for which we've all been locked up in our homes for last 2-3 months now. I know you all are not very happy doing that. You miss your school, your friends, your teachers, everything. And it is very tough. Believe me, it's very tough to go on with the online classes, but there is no option. This is an unprecedented time, but we have to understand that since you'll be going out and you'll be exposed to the disease, you have to understand that the disease is still there. It is still there. So you have to continue with your life, with your normal routine, keeping in mind that the disease is still there. this particular disease is caused by a very small organism, a virus, the coronavirus, which was initially found only in animals, and now it has been found to be transmitted to man and from man to man. Say, suppose if you come across a person who is infected, that person can transmit to you through, if he sneezes or if he coughs, it is there in the surface, and if you touch it, and then from your hand it can go into your, and if you touch your mouth or your nose, it can go into you. So you have to be very careful while you are going out of the house. You have to take certain precautions like using the mask, sanitizing your hand, avoid touching your mouth or your nose. And when you're coming back from school, you have to take precautions that you take off all your clothes and change and have a bath.
Doctor, what are the symptoms of COVID-19 and what should be done if we start to feel these symptoms?
I'll tell you certain symptoms which are commonly found in people who are infected. But nowadays what is happening is the person can be infected, but at the same time there may not be any symptoms. But if you find someone who is coughing, or there is throat pain, there is fever or nasal blockage or lots of taste, then yes, you know that the person is infected. If you get it, if you yourself get it, please go to a doctor, consult a doctor, get the advice, please follow the advice and stay back at home. Take precautions. There's nothing to panic. It is like any other infections, viral infection, but since this particular disease is infecting the human body for the first time, we are not yet ready to fight off the disease, and that is why it has become so worldwide. It has affected so many millions of people, but there is nothing to panic. If you take proper rest, if your immune system is okay, fine, and you take rest and you follow the doctor's advice, you will come out well.
What kind of diet should the children follow, and how to increase the immunity in the children, as this is the only way out till the medicine or vaccine is out?
Disease is very infectious. It can be transmitted easily from one person to another, but at the same time you have to understand that there's nothing to panic. There's no need to panic. You have to increase your immunity, your body's immunity. Immunity means the power of your body to fight off the disease. So that can be done by having proper diet, exercise and sleep. Regarding the diet, it should be like all of you have been, you have been already taking home cooked food. Avoid going out and having all junk food and packaged food and all these things. You have to avoid. You have to take whatever being cooked in your home. Please take those home cooked food, and go for a lot of fruits, vegetables, milk, dairy products. I know most of you all don't like having all these things, but believe me, these are the only alternatives you can have, and that can increase your immunity and help you to fight off the disease. And second part is the exercise. Most of you, I think, will not be able to go out and play with your friends, so you are left with yoga and pranayama at home, and a little bit of meditation also is very helpful. And sleep. Sleep is at least 6 to 7 hours of sleep every day. Helps to rejuvenate your body and helps to to build up the immunity.
What are the precautions to be taken in the school by the kids when the school reopens?
Besides diet, as I told you, yoga and pranayama helps a lot. Improving, helping you to improve your immunity. So you get in touch with proper teachers who can guide you through certain yogasans which helped you to increase the immunity. It is, you know, yoga and pranayama not only helps in to look after your physical health, but it also take care of your mental health and emotional health. That is very, very important, since many of you must be tensed or maybe anxious about the whole thing. So once you start doing yoga and pranayama regularly, that will take care of all these problems. And meditation, at least 5 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes of meditation every day will take care of your mental health as well.
On the behalf of Saint Michael's family, I want to thank you, Dr. Aditi Day, for sharing these valuable information. We also want to thank all the doctors for the difference you make, for the lives you save, for the comfort you give, for your compassion. Thank you for all these and more.
Hope all of you stay well, stay safe, take all the precautions, take proper diet, and you'll be able to fight off the disease. So wishing all of you a very, very happy new normal life.
Children, I know many of you have dreams of becoming doctors one day. I hope your dream comes true and you become savior of this world. So once again, I want to wish all the doctors a very happy Doctor's Day, and I want to prescribe you a day full of smiles.